Israel Singer is a Jewish activist, academic, and former Secretary General of the World Jewish Congress. In the mid-1970s, he taught political science in New York and served on the staff of President Gerald Ford.
I was going to Vladivostok with Air Force One, which at that time was a much less impressive looking plane, and the president was going to have a conversation with, at that time, the Secretary General of the Soviet Union, with Mr. Brezhnev. And I was going along as a shamus because I was at that time working in the White House. And it was possibly one of the first trips that somebody was going from the United States in a relatively important capacity to Vladivostok, which was till then a military district which no Westerners had been in since World War II. And I decided that I was going to not only use this trip, you know, to see Vladivostok, but to see the rest of the Soviet Union, because I had heard of many of the issues that were going on with freedom of religion in the Soviet Union. And I was a professor of politics, and I asked the Rebbe for advice as to where to go, and he told me to as many places as you can. And the Rebbe said, "Are you going to Almaty?" So I told him that's the route to Moscow from Vladivostok. It's on the Trans-Siberian Railway. So he said, "If you can, my father, Oliver Shalom, Levi Yitzchak, maybe you could go to his caver if you have permission." And he told me there's going to be an old man, a Polish man, who knew my father, and you'll see him in shul. He's in shul every day. You'll see him. You'll know him. So I had no idea I'll know him. I'm going to come to a place I've never been before, a language that people know. He says, "You'll be able to speak to him in Yiddish." Very good. I spoke to him. Very good. So anyway, I went first to Birobidzhan, then I went to Khabarovsk, and the train stopped in Almaty. I got off in Almaty. Very good. And I decided to go to Daven. I went to shul in the morning. I looked for a Jew. I found an old Jew. I went over to the old Jew, and I asked him if he knows where, and he looked at me. He says, "Why do you want to know where the Rebbe's father is buried?" So I told him, "Because the Rebbe told me that you're going to tell me where it is." He says, "He told you about me. I'll take you, but you have to be ready tomorrow morning at 4 o'clock in the morning." 4 o'clock in the morning for an American professor is not a usual time. So I went 4 o'clock in the morning. We went in a car. The non-Jew driving the car, I thought the non-Jew was working for the KGB, and for all I know, he probably was working for the KGB. How do I know? Everybody was. Wherever I came, they told me the Jews, the Yiddish-speaking Jews, told me that don't speak to this one because he works for the Drei Oisius. Everybody worked for the Drei Oisius in the 1970s, the KGB. Three ISIS. Everybody worked for the KGB. And so I had no idea who was driving us, but the guy who was driving us knew very well where he was going. And we went to this cemetery, and the Polish Jew told me that the Rebbe's father was the only connection that they had in the city of Almaty to the world which they came from. And that he was the madrich of the whole Golis in Asia. At that time, it was a remarkable experience. When I saw the Rebbe's father's matzeva, and I got a picture of it, and I brought it back to the Rebbe, and he looked at it. He told me that it was a great thing which I did for him, that he wasn't able to do for himself, that I was mekayim kibud av for him. Satem gefelt, he said in Yiddish, it's like he felt as if he would have gone himself. I was very, very moved, and I think he was more moved than me. But the Rebbe did not dwell emotionally long. He put it in his pocket, and he gave me bracha, and then he went on, and he asked me, "Which place did I go to next? What happened in Novosibirsk?" And he wanted to hear what happened in Omsk, and he wanted to hear what happened in Sverdlovsk. He wanted to know what happened in all these places, as if he was a person who lived in all these places. He knew everything about those places, and he was interested in everything, and he obviously had many people who went there, even in a time when no one could go to these places, and he got reports. Anyway, that was the Rebbe's father's story. It turned out to have been one of the most moving experiences of my life, and I've been in many moving experiences.